Let's discuss an important section for transverse view on a string, that is the wave speed of transverse view on a string. We have just discussed that when an oscillator is connected to a stretched string, continuous wave train is produced, and say it is propagating at a speed v. As we have discussed that the speed v depends on the characteristics of the medium, here the medium is the string. So in this situation for the string, we consider the tension in the string is T and its linear mass density is mu kilogram per meter. Tension is measured in Newton. Now in this situation, when the wave train is propagating, if we are required to find what will be the wave speed with which the energy is propagating, we consider a small section on the string, say the section is AB. Let us consider a section at the top of the string. We know well that when the wave is propagating in forward direction, the section AB would be oscillating up and down. We just enlarge this view. You can see in this part of a string, so this is the section AB, due to its curved section, the tension would be acting tangentially at the two points on the section AB. In this situation, if we consider that the section AB is subtending an angle 2 theta, let's consider its angle bisector also, and we consider it subtend an angle 2 theta at the center of curvature of this section AB. In this situation, we just resolve the tension into two components. One is along the direction of propagation, other is perpendicular to that. This angle will also be theta, this is also theta. So here force will be T cos theta, here it will be T sin theta. Similarly, due to this tension, here it is T cos theta and here it is T sin theta. Now, in this situation, we can see these two T cos theta components will cancel each other. Hence, we can say no net horizontal force or along the direction of propagation will be experienced by the part AB of the string. And this 2T sin theta, which is acting toward the center, will be applying a restoring force onto it, due to which it is executing oscillations. So here we can say restoring force on section AB will be 2T sin theta, and if the section AB is very small, angle theta will also be small, so it can be written as 2T theta. If say length of the segment is DL, here this theta can be written as simply we can write as DL upon R. So this 2 theta can be written as T into DL by R. In this situation, this is the net force acting toward the center of curvature of this part AB of the string. Now, in the reference stream of wave, as the wave is propagating at a speed v, we just consider in the reference stream of wave, this section AB will appear to move in backward direction with the same speed v, because actually this section AB is only oscillating up and down, it is at rest. And the wave is propagating forward. So in the reference stream of wave, this section AB appear to move toward the left. So it will experience an inward centripetal force, which is given by this restoring force onto it. So this can be equated to dmv square by r, where dm is the mass of this element AB. If mu is the mass current length, the mass of this section can be simply written as mu into dl, because mu is the mass current length and the mass of length dl can be given as mu dl. So this can be rewritten as T dl by r is equals to mu dl v square by r. Here dl by r gets cancelled out, and on rearranging terms we'll get the wave speed v can be given as root of T by mu. This is quite a useful relation. We'll use it in many applications for waves propagating on a stretched string. So always keep this expression on your tips. We'll also analyze an alternative way to approach this relation of wave speed. Let's also discuss an alternative way. In this alternative method, let's again consider a continuous wave train propagating on a stretched string. And say we consider a small element of length dx on the string, which is having mass dm, which can be written as mu dx if mu is the mass per unit length of the string. And at this instant, we can see this dx will be slightly elongated and at some displacement. On this element, the tension would be acting in the two directions. And if we talk about the slope angles of the string or the displacement curve of the string are at angles theta 1 and theta 2 from horizontal. Here we can say theta 1 and theta 2 would be approximately equal, but slightly theta 2 would be less as it is moving towards the topmost or extreme position where it is becoming zero. So we can say again the horizontal components of the tensions will cancel each other. And if we talk about for the element restoring force, this restoring force can be written as Fr is equals to, for this tension inward component will be T sin theta 1 minus, due to this tension upward component will be T sin theta 2. Now in this situation, sin theta can be obtained by the slope of displacement curve. We can write, for a small theta, sin theta is approximately tan theta, which can be written as del y by del x. For the instantaneous shape of the string, we can easily calculate. So we can write this restoring force as, we can take this t common. It will be del y by del x at position 1. If this element is having its edges at position 1 and position 2. So T sin theta 1 can be written as del y by del x at position 1 minus del y by del x at position 2. Now if we wish to find out the difference of these slopes for the two points which are separated by distance dx along the length of the string, then this restoring force can be written as tension multiplied by the difference in a slope for a small displacement dx can be written as second derivative of the slope multiplied by dx. Now this giving us the variation of a slope with distance along the length of a string. So this multiplied by dx will give us the difference of the two slopes at a displacement dx along the length of the string. Now if this is the restoring force, then we can simply say acceleration of particle, which is here our element in consideration, can be written as restoring force divided by the mass of particle, which is dm, which can be written as mu dx. So it will be fr by mu dx. If we substitute the value of frc, here we'll be getting acceleration, we can write as del square y by del t square is equals to 1 by mu dx multiplied by, we can substitute as t into del square y by del x square into dx. Here this dx gets cancelled out and finally we are getting del square y by del t square is equals to t by mu into del square y by del x square. And this you can compare with the linear wave equation, which we know. Here only we can execute as we know del square y by del t square can be written as v square into del square y by del x square, which we have studied. This is the term we call as curvature of the displacement curve. Comparing these two equations, you can directly get here the wave speed can be written as root of t by mu, which is the same expression, but altogether we have finally approached to the relation in a different way. But the important thing is you need to keep the result in your mind. That is quite useful for you.